I've said this many times, but regarding the Galaxy S25, the reason I'm looking forward to this series is Exynos. Not the Snapdragon 8, but the Exynos 2500. This is because it features Samsung's elite chipset, produced using a 3-nanometer process. Production output of Exynos 2500 was planned. However, due to some issues, they couldn't ensure the necessary quantity. So, it's not included in the Galaxy S25 series. Ignore that the Exynos 2500 might be entirely discontinued, but that's not true. Samsung Electronics continues to maintain Exynos. They seem to be using their strength in technology to hold their position. According to the Snow Economy report, Samsung Foundry, for installation in the Galaxy Z Flip 7, mass production of Exynos 2500 has started. According to the press release, Samsung Electronics plans to release a foldable smartphone next year, the Galaxy Z Flip 7 smartphone. The assembly process during mass production is said to have started at the Huizhou S3 plant. The Exynos 2500 from Samsung production line has been deployed for mass production. I heard rumors about discontinuing the Exynos in the Flip series for a long time. Why do they continue with foldable smartphones? It's still a question whether it's worth it. They have not been able to convince most consumers. With the increasing production costs, the price, and with rising prices, the popularity of foldable smartphones seems to be declining. I feel they are losing their appeal more and more. Their hope that their popularity might diminish. Since it's the Flip series with high sales volumes, the price goes up, equipped with Exynos to suppress this rise. But the issue is the Exynos in the Flip 7. The purpose of holding back price growth is different. According to detailed reports on this situation, the production yield of Exynos 2500 is only 20%. This seems to be an effort to save the foundry biz. I believe this is in favor of Snapdragon. For example, Realme GT Pro with the Elite chipset. There are serious heating problems and benchmark results showing that the actual performance is lower than expected. However, it depends on the product. Since there is the Galaxy S25 to understand, you need to see it yourself. But Exynos, the difference between the Exynos 2500 and Snapdragon 8 Elite is significant. In comparison to the regular Exynos, the performance in the Flip 7, the difference is as big as with Snapdragon. If there's no significant drop in price, there are no updates yet for the Flip 7. It's too early to judge, but if the price, if the advantage is and significant, for now, the Exynos in the Flip, where there was Snapdragon before, the message may be perceived negatively. Considering the Snapdragon Elite, it feels unfortunate to include Exynos. I wonder if the Flip 7 will be released soon with Exynos. Your thoughts on the Exynos Galaxy Z Flip 7? Please leave your comments. Thank you for watching.